Hello guys, so today I'll be sending you all an additional video based on probability technique, which is the fourth under which we are studying right now. The thing is, third one is sensitivity analysis, which will be done tomorrow. But for today, I wanted to complete this topic because it is similar to certainty equivalence technique. Okay, in certainty equivalence, what do? We calculate the certain amount which we are supposed to get, which we are certain that it will come back to us. And in probability technique, when the investor is investing an amount, he has been given particular percentage or a profitability index. Based on that, they are saying that out of the promised amount, the returns that every year we are supposed to give you as an investor, we can, at the worst scenarios, also give you a particular percentage definitely. For that, we calculate probability technique. Now we will be going through a sum so that it will be easy for you. Here we have two mutually exclusive projects whose investment is 6,000 each. Assuming the investment cost of capital at 10%, advise the selection of project based upon the following information. Now again, we have two projects X and Y. They have given cash flows and their probabilities. Okay, so what are the steps in certainty equivalence? Certainty equivalence, what do? First, you calculate your riskless cash flow. Second, you calculate your NPV. Third, you compare again the riskless and the risky cash flows, divide them and get your certainty equivalence. So here nobody is asking you for certainty equivalence. They are asking you for probability that definitely, as promised by the people who have taken your investment, that how much returns you will be getting definitely. For that, we are calculating this. Okay, so let us start. Step 1 is calculation of riskless or definite cash flows, as we have done in certainty equivalence technique. First year 4,000, second year 8,000, 12,000. So in the worst scenarios also, they promise that in the first year, whether they make the profit or they do not make a profit, they will be giving us back 0.2, that is 20% of the investment. Now if you multiply 4,000 into 0.2, it is 800. 8,000 into 0.6 is 4,800. 12,000 into 0.2 is 2,400. Similarly, for the Y project, again they are promising to give us at least 0.2, that is 20% of the returns which they have promised. In the worst case scenarios, anything goes wrong, they do not make any profit, profit is zero for them, even then they will definitely give us 0.2, that is 20% of the promised amount for the first year, that is 8,000. Which is equal to 1600. Similarly, 9000 into 0.5 is 4500, and 9000 divided multiplied by 0.3 is 2700. Now coming to step 2, step 1 is similar, right? Cash flows for both, that is definite amount which we will get in any scenario, that is whether the market is bad, whether they make a profit or whether they do not make a profit. Now coming to step 2, what did we do in step 2? Step 2, we calculated our NPVs. Now NPV, what is the formula for NPV? Sum of, that is adding all these, you get sum of present value of cash inflows minus present value of cash outflow, that is your invested amount. So if you add all these values, you get 8000 minus 6000, that is 2000. And over here you have 8800 minus 6000, that is 2800. Now by comparing the NPVs, which one you would select? You would select that 2800 is the amount I will get back definitely, even though there is a worst market situation, or whether they give back the amount or not, definitely I will get back 2800 is what we have decided. So we will invest into project Y. Thank you for today.